From the Heart, October 4. The Dynamic Duo. Is the law then against the promises of God? Certainly not. The law and the gospel cannot be separated. In Christ, mercy and truth are met together. Righteousness and peace have kissed each other. The gospel has not ignored the obligations due to God by men and women. The gospel is the law unfolded, nothing more nor less. It gives no more latitude to sin than does the law. The law points to Christ. Christ points to the law. The gospel calls us to repentance. Repentance of what? Of sin. And what is sin? It is the transgression of the law. Therefore, the gospel calls sinners from their transgression back to obedience to the law of God. Jesus, in his life and death, taught the strictest obedience. He died, the just for the unjust, the innocent for the guilty, that the honor of God's law might be preserved, and yet humanity not utterly perish. The work of salvation in both the Old and New Testament dispensation is the same. Satan is working with all his deceptive power to ensnare the world. He would have them believe that this great sacrifice was made in order to abolish God's law. He represents Christ as opposed to the law of God's government in heaven and in earth. But the sovereign of the world has a law by which to govern his heavenly intelligences and his human family, and the death of his son fixes the immutability of that law beyond any question. God has no intention of doing away with his great standard of righteousness. By this standard, he can define what a correct character is. It is necessary that every intelligent being shall understand the principles of the law of God. Christ, through the Apostle James, declares, "Whosoever shall keep the whole law, and yet offend in one point, he is guilty of all." These words were spoken this side of the death of Christ. Therefore, the law was binding upon all at that time. People may talk of freedom, of gospel liberty. They may assert that they are not in bondage to the law. But the influence of a gospel hope will not lead sinners to look upon the salvation of Christ as a matter of free grace while they continue to live in transgression of the law of God. When the light of truth dawns upon their minds, and they fully understand the requirements of God and realize the extent of their transgressions, they will reform their ways, become loyal to God, through the strength obtained from their Savior, and lead a new and purer life.